on Crook and Chase. It's a weird night, let me tell you. Now?
This group is celebrating.
And so is. I'll tell you what.
No. So is Reba McEntire, who celebrated a sweet 16 last night. Her 16th number one single, It's Your Call. As Jan Snyder reports, Reba not only knows how to pick a song, she knows how to pick the writers.
This TV ad ran at the beginning of the year, and it worked. Along with all the other marketing wizardry for Reba McEntire's album, It's Your Call. Last night, Reba and the song's writers celebrated the title cut's number one status.
Congratulations to these fine writers. It was a hit song, and we're proud to publish it, and we're proud of Reba for having such a huge monster year, and we want to do it again, Reba.
I understand. Word has it that you're pretty quick, that you can hear relatively quickly whether or not the song's for you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the chill bumps start, and they go all the way up to my face. And when I heard It's Your Call, my face had chill bumps on it throughout the whole song.
And as the co-writers will tell you, a good idea can come from the simplest inspiration.
Can you share with us where the idea came from?
Well, it was actually a soap opera. And the guy was just talking to the woman and said, hey, honey, it's your call. And I said, there it is. I've been looking for that for a long time.
And she called me up and she said, do you want to write this? And we called Bruce up and said, do you want to write this? I always knew she was going to do the song. I just had a feeling in my heart that she was going to do this song. Bruce and Liz had to be convinced that it was on hold, that she was actually going to record the song, it was going to happen. I just kept saying, it's okay, she's going to do it. But I don't think they were really convinced of it until it was recorded.
And a little added spice to the whole celebration. Liz and Shauna are writers for Starstruck Publishing. In a way, they're Reba's employees.
It's a baby group. We've not been together for very long, but it's been a great group of very creative, hungry people that want to do well. And Liz Hingbird has been a co-writer on both of the songs, For My Broken Heart and It's Your Call.
So the obvious question, did Reba choose to record those songs because they are Starstruck property?
I never have a preference over publishing company or writer. Never. And I've even written some of them that I passed on myself. I don't care who writes them or who publishes them. They have to be the best songs. I won't do that to my fans.
Well, Reba says she chose to listen to the song because Linda Davis, one of her favorite singers, and just happens to be one of her backup singers, sang the demo.
It is an excellent